Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. Welcome to the opening ceremonies for the 99th annual Feast of the Blessed Sacrament. We're here on a beautiful day with no rain, and we anticipate that the sun will be breaking through any second. Traditionally, we start our opening ceremonies with a blessing from Father Reese. So I'm going to ask Father Daniel Reese if you would please give an invocation.
Boa tarde. Mais uma vez gostaria de expressar como verdadeiramente é uma honra e é ao mesmo tempo um prazer estar associado todos os anos a esta festa do Santíssimo Sacramento, que é a grande festa da nossa comunidade, é a grande festa que a todos nós nos une ao longo destes dias. Nós iniciamos precisamente esta festa, acabamos de vir agora, da presença do Santíssimo Sacramento, que foi a presença de Jesus na Eucaristia, e estivemos precisamente a invocar os festeiros que estiveram reunidos, a invocar a bênção do Senhor, a bênção de Jesus na Eucaristia, sobre estes dias de festa. Então, é neste sentido que, unindo essa festa com o Parque da Igreja da Imaculada Conceição, mais uma vez aqui estou para invocar essas mesmas bênçãos do Senhor. Como acabamos de dizer, invocamos na Igreja e agora vamos estender a todos que aqui estão presentes e a todos aqueles que ao longo destes dias vão participar nesta festa, dessa mesma oração de bênção que o Senhor, portanto, derrame sobre nós ao longo destes dias. Então, para tal, eu gostava de convidar o Sr. Padre Manuel Ferreira, que ao longo dos anos tem sido sempre, estado sempre associado a esta festa, durante vários anos, como pároco da Imaculada Conceição, mas continuou sempre a ter uma união muito grande e profunda com a festa do Santíssimo Sacramento. Então, através do Padre Ferreira, vamos invocar as bênçãos do Senhor.
I thought I was going to be disguised, that they wouldn't recognize me. But as I think of what to say, I look up and see two flags of two great nations, Portugal and the United States, and the other flag of Madeira. The flag of Portugal represents those who came to these shores to begin a new land, a new life for themselves and their families. They came to the United States with open arms and made their lives better and more complete. But they brought with them tradition, faith, they brought with them their hard work, their labors, what they knew, what was in themselves, body and soul. And so, today we celebrate, and we'll celebrate till the end of this week, not only our Portuguese heritage, but the Madeiran heritage and legacy that has been really for around 100 years. So good luck to the Madeiran community on this feast day, and celebrate it with pride, with joy, and good weather. I ask God's blessing upon all of us here present, that He bless us one and all, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
A double blessing, you can't beat that. Also, in keeping with tradition, I would like to recognize the elected officials who have taken time out of a very busy schedule to be here with us this afternoon. And we'll start with our state representative who's here, Tony Cabral. When I get to the end of the list, if I've forgotten anyone, please let me know. Also here from the city of New Bedford, we have Councilors at Large, Mr. David Alves, Councilor at Large Deborah Coelho, Councilor at Large Brian Gomes, And Councillor at Large John Saunders. John's in the crowd somewhere. Way in the back. Our Dennis Lawrence is also here. Councillor at Large Dennis, hiding in the back, he's traveling incognito. Ward Councillor from Ward 4, Bruce Duarte. Ward Councillor from Ward Number 5, Jane Gonzaves. From Ward 6, Joe Lopes. Ward Councillor from Ward 2, Steve Martins. And from the North End, Councillor Jim Oliveira from Ward 1. We thank all of you for taking time out and being here with us. The flags that you see behind me traditionally are raised at this time. I am pained to tell you that we have had some technical difficulties with the rope mechanism that raises them. So what we're going to do instead is to play the national anthems of Madeira, Portugal, and the United States. And we are going to ask a member of our folkloric dance group, Jason Sylvia, if he would lead us in the Madeiran anthem. Jason?
Do vale à montanha e do mar à serra, teu povo humilde, estoico e valente, entre a rocha dura te livrou a terra para lançar do pão a semente. Herói do trabalho na montanha agreste, que se fez ao mar em vagas procilosas, os louros da vitória em tuas mãos calosas foram herança que a teus filhos deste. Por esse mundo além, Madeira, teu nome continua. Em teus filhos saudosos, que além fronteiras de ti se mostram orgulhosos. Por esse mundo além, Madeira, honraremos vossa história. Na senda do trabalho, nós lutaremos, alcançaremos teu bem-estar e glória. Heróis do mar, nobre povo, nação valente e imortal, levantai hoje de novo o esplendor de Portugal. Entre as brumas da memória, ó pátria, sente-se a voz dos seus egrégios avós, que há de guiar-te à vitória. Às armas, sobre terra, sobre o mar. Às armas, pela pátria lutar. Contra os canhões marchar, marchar.
I'm not going to raise the mic because I'm going to need to lower it even a little bit more. We're going to have our national anthem, the U.S. national anthem, sung by the daughter of the president of this year's feast committee. This is Melandia Coutinho, ladies and gentlemen, and give her a warm welcome. And in respect to the U.S. flag, We'd like to ask everyone in the audience to remove their hats and hand over your heart would be appropriate. Thank you. How did she hit those high notes? Thank you, Melandia. Before we go any further, it is appropriate that all of us gathered together today pay respect to those members who cannot be here. They are in the clouds looking down at us. To lay the memorial wreath, Jeff Coutinho has asked his uncle and his dad to grab the wreath that's over here and put it in front of the monument. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Gabe Coutinho and Mr. Joseph Coutinho. Thank you very much. When you have hundreds of people, including more than 53 members of a feast committee, working for 1 year to put together a celebration, you have to take on a lot of different jobs, a lot of different tasks, and many of them involve the place where you hold it. The feast grounds are private property, but the area around us is not. And to make this accessible and to make it easier for all of you, we try to work as close as we can with all of the various departments in the city, as well as its number one executive. It is with great pleasure that I introduce the mayor of New Bedford, Mayor John Mitchell.
More time. Hey, it's Feast Week. And it's not going to R-A-I-N. I'm not even going to say the word. I don't want to jinx us. And it doesn't matter anyway, does it? It doesn't matter. Listen, you know, there's one public official I want to acknowledge and make a point to, and that's my friend Fred Kalitz, former mayor, who was right up at Collette Street. Mayor Kalitz, I want to make a point something out. Mayor Kalitz and I, neither of us are lucky enough to be Madeiran. We're proud to be Polish, both of us. Two Polish mayors, but there's a point here, and that's this. Whether you're Madeiran or not, whether you're Portuguese or not, the feast is part of you. It's part of New Bedford. This feast is something that any city in America would die for. This is arguably the premier ethnic festival, not just in Massachusetts. It's by far and away that. It's one of the premier ethnic festivals in America. And it's not just because of the big crowds. It's because of all of you. It's because you've stayed true, every one of you, the committee, all the festas, everybody has stayed true to the roots of this ceremony, the roots of this festival. It's about family, it's about faith, it's about a rich culture that has fantastic food, fantastic dance, fantastic songs. Everybody comes together this week to celebrate something special. And in an America that is becoming more homogenous and more the same, and everybody's becoming more like everybody else, this is what makes us true. This is what makes our city a novel place and a special place to be. And I'm very proud to be the mayor of a city that can pull this off year in and year out and be true to itself. So I want to thank the committee for all of your hard work. I know the work for next year for number 100 is going to start on Monday. Actually, take a day off. Start on Tuesday. I want to thank Larry Jakes for his stewardship of the organization year in and year out. It's getting better and better every year. Jeff Coutinho and your daughter with a beautiful voice. I know she doesn't get that from you, Jeff. Great job stepping up this year. You've done a fantastic job. You've made us proud. I walked the site. Let's hear it for Jeff. The site looks great. The women will be pleased. If you don't know it already, brand new women's rooms here. There won't be any lines. It's clean. It looks great. I mentioned that because, in all seriousness, that the time that these gentlemen have put in and their families have put in over the course of the year pays off. The feast is becoming bigger and better every year. We need to, next year, especially for 100, bring back a lot of people who haven't been here in a long time, and to reach out and bring in the rest of America who will be introduced to it for the first time on the 100th feast. It's going to be a big event, and it's going to be an opportunity for this city to really shine. So we look forward to all that. But first, we're going to have a great time this year. Let me acknowledge a couple of women here who for whom this is a special event. One of whom is a Madeiran girl, City Councilor Jane Gonzalez, for whom this will be her last feast as Ward 5 Councilor. And I know this has always been a very special event for her, but Jane, I just wanted to say thanks for all you've done for the city. Thanks for all you've done for Madeirans, especially in the city. And I just ask everybody to join me in a round of applause for Jane. There's another last feast here too, at least for official purposes, and that's for our Portuguese consul, Gracia Fonseca, who has been our consul for 4 years now, 5 years now. We can't thank you enough for not only your stewardship of the Portuguese community here and creating the connections with the homeland, but just being here and being at every ceremony along the way. You've really made the connections real back to the homeland, and we're going to miss you a lot. I know you're going to have great success in your next stop, Gracia, but we all want to just say thank you, and I would ask everybody to join me in a round of applause for her. Listen up, everybody. We'll get you into the feast in a second. I'll wrap up, but have a great time this weekend, and let's bring in more people next year. Let's go.
As the mayor said, it's a bittersweet moment. The sweetness is that we get to hear from our Portuguese consul, Graça Fonseca. The bitterness is that on Sunday after the parade, she's leaving to go to Boston to get on an airplane and go back to Lisbon. It is my pleasure to introduce, for the last time on this platform, the Portuguese consul to the great city of New Bedford, Graça Fonseca.
Well, good afternoon, everybody. It's my pleasure, my honor. It has been throughout these 4 years of my tenure to participate officially in this ceremony of the opening of the feasts and also in the feast itself. It's a great moment to celebrate the friendship and our cultural heritage, Portuguese heritage and Madeiran heritage. This feast is more than a feast. It's a bond between friends, a meeting point of friends from all over the country. And it's a feast that really reflects the social and the ethnic diversity of this city. As the mayor just pointed out, the great city of New Bedford has different ethnicities, but we all get together in this really great feast. I see the festeiros, they have been working tirelessly in the last year, maybe a bit more intensely in the last month. I would like to congratulate them, congratulate the president of the feast committee this year, Jeff Coutinho, who is taking over with very brightly the job that his predecessors, his ancestors also took. I would like to congratulate also the president of the feast, Club Madeira Santíssimo Sacramento, Larry Jack. Thank you very much for inviting me. I know that the wives of the members of the club also perform a very crucial role in getting this great feast in its highest success. I also would like to address congratulations for them. And really, this is also a special moment for me personally. I have always been received with courtesy, with warmth, with kindness by all the members. I felt myself part of the family throughout these years. And I believe that I will continue being a fan of the club, of the feast, of all the environment that we experience here. It's really a great atmosphere. Because of the people, basically, the people just create this warmth. I would like to thank you for all your kindness, the way you treated me, you received me. Thank you very much. And I will see you in the feast, and I will enjoy it happily with your company. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Graça. Just a few more to go, and then we'll be smelling linguica frying on the grills. We'd like to ask the City Council President, Bruce Duat, if you would step forward. I believe that you might have something for us.
I do. I have a New Bedford City Council official resolution, but before we do that, I'd just like to say a few words. First, Jeff, the pride of a father, that was beautiful. Your daughter did an absolutely wonderful job. You put tears in my eyes as I watched you with pride as your daughter saying. I thought that was absolutely phenomenal. You know, the fact is the mayor's right. This is the premier feast in the world, I believe. This is the biggest Portuguese feast in the world. Something we can all be proud of. Every single member of the committee that puts this together, the city workers who help putting this together should be commended as well. The city council and our role working with the committee to make sure that this happens is something that we should all be proud of, because it's a city effort, it's a city initiative, and each one of us should be proud about this feast. You know, I was listening to Father Reyes, you know, he made me reflect on what this feast is really about. And during his sermon, which I thought was phenomenal, I thank you for that, he said, you know, let's not forget what the feast is all about. The roots of the feast, to look up and thank the person who makes this all possible for all the blessings that he's bestowed, not only on this feast, our city, our country, to give him thanks every now and again. So with that being said, I'd like to read this New Bedford City Council official resolution. Be it hereby known to all that the City Council of the Bedford, Massachusetts, hereby offers its sincerest congratulations to the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament, 99th year, in recognition of the dedicated work of the committee members and wishing them continued success. The entire Synastry extends its very best wishes on this memorable occasion and expresses the hope for continued good fortune given this first day of August, 2013, signed by myself, the council president, and with all my colleagues, given their best wishes as well. Thank you for all you folks do to represent our city and make us all proud. Thank you very much.
Our club, Madeiran and Sacramento, is 350-plus members strong. We are led by a man of tremendous strength and foresight and the ability to grasp just about every problem and take the bull by the horns. It's my pleasure to introduce the president of the Club Madeiran, Mr. Larry Jakes.
Thank you. I'm going to make it short. I just want to thank everybody for coming to the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament. Right, Father Reese? The Feast of the Blessed Sacrament, isn't it? You told me that a few years ago, and I never forgot that. But I do want to tell Jeff something and his group. You know, I'm going to say the R word. When it rains, when you get married, that means good luck. And you've been married to these guys for the last year. Okay? So that was just a little shower. Didn't bother anybody. But that's my theory. And today, we're all from all different nationalities, but for this weekend, we're all Madeiran. And that's what I wanted to say. And I want to thank each and every one of you for being here today. I want you to enjoy yourself, have a safe 4 days, and really enjoy the entertainment that you will get for free. And everybody else will, and our wives and our girlfriends. I don't have a girlfriend, but a wife. Oh, she's right there. She said, I better not. But anyway, I want to thank you all for being here, and thank you again. Thanks.
Right on schedule. We're down to the wire, and the keys are in the locks, the grills have heated up, and we're ready to go. A final speaker before we start our feast, ladies and gentlemen, the president of the 99th Feast of the Blessed Sacrament, Mr. Jeff Coutinho.
First of all, welcome to the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament, the 99th year. It gives me such honor to look around, see my fish teiros. They're all brothers. They're families, fathers, sons. I'm very proud to carry on the tradition started by my grandfather and three friends 99 years ago. This year, we had a saying, tradition, family, and friends. And you'll see it on some of our shirts. This is exactly what it means. We thank everybody that has come out to support us for 4 more days. We're going to have good weather. We're going to have good fun. And let's keep this tradition going. Welcome to the feast. Steve. Vamos pra festa.
Everyone, enjoy the feast.
Because my husband is Madeiran. Get over here. This is Richard. And we have been working the feast for years and years. My father-in-law was the one that got involved in this, Charles Fernandes. and we've just been doing it for him and for his heritage. So we bartend at Stand 6, the big bar at the pavilion, and stop by and have fun. We're here every year.
Tonight because a bunch of friends asked me to come, and the woman that's over there doing interviews for the Standard Times, this is her first time here at the Madeira Feast, so I came to accompany her, and I know that my husband will be here soon and my friends, and I love coming here to see people I haven't seen in years. It's just like a reunion.
Like, people come from, like, out of state, and this has been, like, I think the 100th year that this feast has been going on, and it's pretty cool. Everyone coming in and just enjoying some Madeiran wine and everything. It's nice.
menu here is pretty big. Is there any one thing that you enjoy the most?
Well, I like the Cardinal Spit myself. Usually I get together with a few friends. We come down to the fire pit. We cook the Cardinal Spit. Enjoy that, because we run into people here too at the pit. And the food is just fantastic.
My name's Teddle Point. I'm from originally born and raised in New Bedford, and live now in Pensacola, Florida, and came up to surprise my mom. And we brought our good friend, Yvette McClellan, and her husband, to enjoy the Portuguese feast.
This is a lot bigger than I expected. Nothing compares to what we are doing here. It's wonderful. The Madeira wine is out of this world. I've never had it before, but I'm bringing some home.
Good buddy of mine who lives in Pensacola is from New Bedford, and he's Portuguese, his mom, so this is a big festival, and they invited us to come up here and attend it this year.
John, you've been here for about an hour. What do you think of it?
This is fantastic. This is one of the best festivals I've ever been to.
And what are you going to eat tonight? Got something?
Well, we got the shish kebabs with the onions and the peppers on there and the salt and the Madeira wine.
And the Madeira wine.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Don't waste all the Madeira wine on the meat. You know that, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You know, the feast committee is always aware of what things need to be improved, and they listen to people like me and others who come all the time and say, can you do this? Can you improve that? And I know that the feast committee is always willing to look at ways to improve the feast, to just make the experience a little bit better. And that's why every year it improves and gets better experience for everybody.
Hello, New Bedford, the 99th birthday of the Madeira Feast. Am I excited? And I have with me Jennifer, and I am Counselor Deborah Coelho, and this is exciting. And we are right near the fire pit. Jennifer, can you feel the heat?
Absolutely. But you know what? It feels nice. It's a cool night tonight, so it's really good. And it smells delicious.
Does it? Really? Jennifer, tell me three things that you absolutely adore about the feast.
The food, the wine, and the entertainment. I mean, that's like the best part. I think they should have the feast every weekend, personally, but it's always my favorite time of year. It's great between, like I said, the food, the music, the wine. It's good.
And what about me?
Absolutely, my favorite host.
You know what? We adore this feast. We really love all the people. First and foremost, the people that we see year after year. Some of them I call the anchor people, because you know what? They're always like on the same spot.
I know. That's true. You're right. You're absolutely right. I'm actually not in my spot right now. I should be up near the Madeira House right now.
My name's Jessica. I like the food at this feast. It's really good.
I'm Marlena Bolero, and I really like the cassola.
I'm JD Humphreys, and we're here to party. That's what we're here for. Thank you.
know it's the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament. It's a huge Portuguese feast, but I really only know that because I'm half Portuguese, so.
What do you like about it?
What's not to like? There's food and rides and music and Portuguese people, like.
I see lots of families and children. I see older folks, including myself. I'm not that old, really. But anyway, all different ages out here, and that's great. It's a culture that comes together once a year, as I'm mistaken by this, and they seem to enjoy their culture, and that's what they're doing. They're celebrating their culture here, and I think that's a wonderful thing to celebrate your culture.
Physical activity a day and eating well can help get your child healthy. So keep them active and eating well every day. Get ideas, get involved, get going at letsmove.gov. That's letsmove.gov.